okay, guys, I didn't know if I wanted to start on Kick or Twitch today. I'm like, I'm in a weird place this whole week. Like, I am like exhausted right now, and I hate that I'm so tired. Like, I cleaned today, like all day. I woke up at 7 a.m. and I'm like beat. I've never done so much adventuring, and then I also, you know, the streamer awards, which we got to talk about, and you know, the family still being in town, and then we went to Joshua Tree, and I'm just like, I've been all over the dang place, and lots of cooking and cleaning and nonstop. I don't think I had a break. The only time I had a break was like when I was sitting alone in Joshua Tree drinking a beer, hanging out on a hammock for like a couple hours. I should have just... Oh, the internet was so bad. I couldn't even stream, though. Terrible internet.
At least you had internet.
Yeah, that's true. At least I had internet. Yeah, so streamer awards. So for some reason, you know, I got the message from Twitch manager, you know, not going to name any names. They messaged me, you know, hey, you want to go March 11th? It says SAT, March 11th. Your girl read Sunday.
You had one job.
Then I thought Sunday was March 11th. I didn't even like think about the days of the week or anything. Cause it was even Chris's birthday, the March 10th. So like I should have assumed 11th the next day. Nope, over my head. I think like just thinking about the stream rewards, just thinking about the family coming. You know, every time I mentioned Sunday, I mentioned you guys Sunday. Going to the stream rewards.
I didn't know when the date was. I just heard it was Sunday.
Yeah, everybody I mentioned Sunday. Literally, even Erica that's going to the stream rewards. Even some people that are going to the stream rewards. And nobody corrected me. Not one person. And then at like almost 11 p.m. the night before the streamer awards actual date, me and Jen are like messaging each other on TikTok, and she goes, oh yeah, so the streamer awards are tomorrow. I'm like, what? They're Sunday. And then I go and double check the date in my DMs. Saturday, March 11th. So your girl panicked because I didn't have a dress. I didn't have like my hair and makeup planned. I had it all planned for Sunday. And so I'm like, well, I guess I was going to get like a mani-pedi. You know, I was going to do the whole thing the next day. And then so I was like, well, it's going to be fun. But I was actually happy that it was Saturday, because like I didn't have a chance to like get anxiety to even really think about it, because it was just like, well, it's here. It's the next day now. And, you know, I got my dress luckily at like noon, and it kind of fit. It was kind of tight. I got some hips, and so like my hips like kind of pop out of them, so that was annoying. But you know, I was like, whatever, you know, are people really gonna comment on my hips popping out of my dress, you know, little muffin hips, whatever, I don't know. I didn't care. But I ended up pulling it together, went shopping for my shoes, got a little clutch outfit, showed up last person behind Pokey. I was right behind Pokey and Lulu. They were the last people, and like the cutoff was Pokey for the interviews. It was Pokey, Lulu, and then me. And Lulu was Pokey was the cutoff for interviews, and then we were done. So like I didn't get to even get a chance to do the red carpet interviews. I was doing it. Like I was standing in line, like ready to go. I posted a picture in Discord. I was like ready to go. I was gonna do it. I was like, yeah, you got this. Confidence. Woohoo. And right behind Lulu, I'm like, damn, do I really have to go behind Lulu? Like they're gonna be like, who's this chick after her? But whatever. Anyway, she looked hot. Everybody looked so freaking beautiful and amazing. And Pokey's dress was like out of this world. I was like, holy sheesh. Yeah, but I got my photos. I basically hung out with the Twitch people the whole time, because I didn't have any friends. Like, no, all my friends were in general admission. I tried meeting up with like Cheer Girl and Erica, but like we're cut off completely. Like when you're in VIP and you get like...
Wait, so were they like upstairs?
Yeah, they were up above me. So we get this view, like we're all downstairs. We get served food, drinks, open bar, which I was trying to behave. Like I know, like if I'm in a social situation, I'm gonna drink the crap out of the drinks. And I'm like, nope, we're gonna sip on some wine. I got a vodka soda start to like kill the nerves. And then I just had wine for the rest of the night. And then, you know, obviously the after party, we'll get to that. But, and everybody, like the awards itself were really cool. I kind of, I'm a weirdo. I get like emotional over, I guess like happy situations, or seeing people like being successful or doing what they love, or And like just seeing like me involved in the world of streaming at all is just like super cool. Like I was there, I'm a part of this community, and just seeing what it's about, like all the people, all the creators, all different creators I never even heard of, and what is kind of like evolving into. I feel like a lot of just chatting and gaming, like variety gaming more so, is like blowing up more so than anything. And I found a lot out. It was pretty inspirational in a way, and met some cool people. I became friends with like two girls there, which, you know, they're really sweet, and they also are more popular than I am. I shouldn't even been there. I don't know, but it was cool. And yeah, I basically hung out with Twitch people because they made me feel comfortable, and we just had drinks. And then the after party happens. It's like a mansion house in the hills. It's like 20 minutes, 30 minutes from the place. They made some freaking crazy jokes on some of the streamers though, like harsh, but pretty truthful. Anyway, yeah, so we get to the party. There's this girl running around in a red dress. She, you know, like when you look in somebody's eyes and they look like they're gone already?
Yeah.
Like she was not there. Like you could tell, like she was gone, like blacked out, like probably won't remember what happened. She's like yelling, "Where's X? Where's X?" And I'm like, "I don't know who you are. I don't know. And there's this other girl like trying to like chase her around. And come to find out, like I hung out for a while. So I hung out for a while, had a couple more drinks, a couple more vodka sodas. I actually talked to Lulu, which she was like the only like genuine person that like we just actually like had a conversation with. But you know, I'm super awkward. So like towards the end of our conversation, we kind of just like, you know, just like separated. And I felt bad because like we didn't even say bye. I didn't go like, "Nice meeting you." It was just like, it's like, well, darn. But I don't know. If I were to say bye, I'd be like, "You're amazing. Thanks for, you know, representing all the women in such a good way and like BR and like such a freaking toxic environment." But you know, whatever. We're done with that. She's great. We talked about like cooking and all that stuff and how I want to do cooking streams more and get away from just straight shooters, FPS and BR. But yeah. Yeah, the girl later on, hours later, it was a few hours, where like we get this alarm going off. "Party's over, party's over, the ambulance is here, da 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 da." And I'm just like, "What? What are we saying right now? What are we talking about?" And I guess the girl that I saw in the red dress was the girl Minx, which I later, like Erica even messaged me like an article and stuff. Turns out she has an alcohol addiction, and she got like super drunk before the party, which is like really shitty to see because it's like an open bar and she like promised not to drink. And the girl, she's clearly hammered. Like I saw her at the party, like when we first walked in. And I saw her at the party and she was, you know, gone. And I guess she like did a crazy thing in front of the ambulance, like passed out, like knocked over, act like she was injured. I guess later on she tried throwing shit in the pools and stuff. Like we left. I left at like midnight. I was on my best behavior. I was like, I want to get home. I don't want to get obliterated. I don't want to feel like shit tomorrow because the family was visiting and stuff. But like this girl like ruined the party for everybody, which is really shitty because there were freaking so many people there. Like all the big names you could think of were at the party. Like you walk outside, you know, you got Valk, you got freaking XQC and all them. I think Lud was there, you know, obviously Cutie and all them. And it's just like, and Myth, and it's like so many legends were there that we've known for like years. And it's just, you got too drunk and one person ruined the party for like everybody. But you know, whatever. Hopefully she learns from it. That's like the best you can take from it, learning from it and realizing mistakes, trying to get better and sober up or whatever it takes, or learn to control your alcohol. But I feel like, I don't know, once you're in that deep, it must be pretty rough. But it was cool. It was a really cool party. They had a DJ and the mansion was amazing. Epic views. It was like literally a hillside. So, but yeah. I had a good time. One thing I wish, I took more photos because I'm terrible at taking pictures in public. Like, I hate taking pictures of myself. I hate being like, you know, I don't like being that person. And then, I wish I was a little more comfortable. Like, I wish I didn't have, like, imposter syndrome, how people say imposter syndrome. Because it's, like, an actual thing. You don't feel, you know, I know, like, people look up to me. I know people enjoy my streams and everything. It's just, like, I feel like I'm not at that big league. And seeing them, I feel like I'm just another person, like, trying to meet them or trying to clout chase when I actually just want to have conversations and, I don't know, have common interests, and I just want to like chat and nerd out and do everything and actually meet good friends, mainly women in the industry, because I, you know, it's nice to have more ladies to play with. But yeah, I only really talk to Lulu and Twitch managers and the Chelsea girl that I met. She's super sweet. But yeah, it's the only moment. Cool. Yeah, so I don't know. I wish I was a little more confident in talking to people, but it's fine. I just like kind of hung out in my corner and drank and people watched for the most part, which isn't a terrible thing. But maybe one day, you know, I'll be on the big screen hanging out with the cool people and stuff. I don't know.